been working with philanthropic organizations and have started a fund focused on empowering women in impoverished parts of the world. This is why perhaps I have such great admiration and empathy for Hillary Clinton. I have great admiration for her because I know what it takes in some small measure to do what she has done. She is obviously incredibly intelligent, focused, tough, determined, empathetic of all the tens of millions of people that she was trying to represent in her quest to become the first woman president of the United States. And as a woman, I take great pride in the fact that Hillary Clinton ran for president. And I also watched with a lot of empathy as I saw how she was scrutinized, characterized, talked about as a woman. While I think women have made great progress in so many ways, I also know from personal experience that women in positions of power, particularly bold women who are trying to drive change, as Hillary Clinton most surely is, bold women, women in power, are characterized and scrutinized differently than their male counterparts are. Now, of course, all of us as Americans, and particularly all of us as women, have a very important choice. Women are, of course, hugely important in this election. We represent 52% of the voters. We start small businesses at twice the rate that men do. And small businesses create 75% of the jobs in this country. So women are a driving force, not just in politics, but women are a driving force in our economy. And how women choose in November will say much about the direction of our nation.